some popular models of parallel programming. So here is first a shared memory model. In the shared memory programming model, tasks share a common address space which they read and write asynchronously. Various mechanisms such as locks, semaphores may be used to control access to the shared memory. An advantage of this model from the programmer's point of view is that program development can often be simplified. An important disadvantage of this model in terms of performance is that for this model, data management is difficult. Then second is threads model. In this model, a single process can have multiple concurrent execution paths. The main program is scheduled to run by native operating system. It loads and acquires all the necessary software and user resources to activate the process. A thread's work may best be described as subroutine within the main program. Any thread can execute any one subroutine, and at the same time it can execute other subroutines. Threads communicate with each other through global memory. So this requires synchronization construct to ensure that more than one thread is not updated the same global address at any time. So threads can be created and destroyed, but the main program remains live to provide the necessary shared resources until the application has completed. So threads are commonly associated with shared memory architecture and operating system. Message passing model. So in the message passing model, there exists a set of tasks that use their own local memory during computation. Multiple tasks can reside on the same physical machine as well as across an arbitrary number of machines. So tasks exchange data by sending and receiving messages. In this model, data transfer usually requires cooperation among operations that are performed by each process. For example, a send operation must have matching receive operation. Next one is data parallel model. In the data parallel model, most of the parallel work focuses on performing operation on a data set. So data set is typically organized into a common structure such as an array or queue. A set of tasks work collectively on the same data structure, with each task working on different portion of the same data structure. So tasks perform same operation on their partition of work. For example, add 3 to every array element can be one task. In shared memory architecture, all tasks may have access to the data structure through the global memory. So in the distributed memory architecture, the data structure is split up and data resides as chunk in the local memory of each task. Hybrid model. So the hybrid model are generally tailor-made models suiting to specific applications. Actually, these fall in the category of mixed models, such as type of application-oriented model keep cropping up. Other parallel programming models exist and will continue to evolve corresponding to new applications. In this type of model, any two or more parallel programming models are combined. Currently, a common example of hybrid model is the combination of message passing model. So, with either the thread mode, POSIX thread, or the shared memory model, OpenMP. So, this hybrid model lends itself well to the increasingly common hardware environment of networked SMP machine. Another common example of hybrid model is combining data parallel model with message passing model. As mentioned earlier in the data parallel model, data parallel implementation F90 HPF on distributed memory architecture actually use message passing to transit data transparently between tasks and the programmer. So next one is SPMD, single processing multiple data. Is actually a high-level programming model that can be built upon any combination of previously mentioned parallel programming model. A single program is executed by all tasks simultaneously. SPMD programs usually have necessary logic programmed into them to allow different tasks to branch or conditionally execute only those parts of the program they are designed to execute. So that is, tasks do not necessarily have to execute the entire program. They may execute only a portion of. In this model, different tasks may use different data. MPMD, multiple program, multiple data. Like SPMD, single program, multiple data, is actually a high-level programming model MPMD is also actually a high level programming model that can be built upon any combination of previously mentioned parallel program models. So MPMD application typically have multiple executable object files programs. While the application is being run in parallel, each task can be executed on the same or different program. In this model, all tasks may use different data. So let's come to parallel virtual machine. The software is highly portable. PVM is basically a simulation of computer machine running parallel program. It is a software package that permits heterogeneous connection of Unix or Windows computer hooked together by a network to be used as a single large parallel computer. It includes a combination of good features of various operating systems and architecture. Thus, large computation problem can be solved more cost effectively by using combined power memory of many computers. So the software is highly portable and the source which is available free through netlib and has been compiled on range of computing machines from laptop to Cray machines. So PVM enable user to exploit the existing computer hardware to solve much larger problem at minimum additional cost. So hundreds of sites around the world are using PVM to solve important scientific, industrial, medical problems. Further, PVM are being used as an educational tool to teach parallel programming. With tens of thousands of users, PVM has become the de facto standard for distributing computing worldwide. So, our next topic is grid computing. Grid computing means applying the resources of many computers in a network simultaneously to a single problem for solving scientific or technical problems. So that requires a large number of computer processing cycles, accesses to large amount of data. So grid computing uses software to divide distribute pieces of program to as many as several thousands computer. So a number of corporations, professional groups and university consortia have developed frameworks and software for managing grid computing projects. So thus, a grid computing model allows companies to use a large number of computation resources on demand, irrespective of where they are located. Various computational tasks can be performed using computational grid. Grid computing provides clustering of remotely distributed computing environment. So the principal focus of grid computing to date has been on maximizing the use of available processor resources for compute intensive applications. Grid computing along with storage virtualization and server virtualization enable a utility computing. Normally it has graphical user interface, which is a program interface based on the graphics capability of the computer to create screen or windows. Grid computing uses the resources of many separate computers connected by network, usually the internet, to solve large-scale computation problem. The SETI at Home project, launched in mid-1990s, was the first widely known grid computing project, and it has been followed by many other projects covering tasks such as protein folding, research into drugs for cancer, and mathematical problem and climate models. So grid computing offers a model for solving massive computational problem by making use of unused resources, CPU cycles and disk storage of large number of disparate, often desktop computer treated as virtual cluster embedded in a distributed telecommunication infrastructure. Grid computing focuses on ability to support computation across administrative domain, which sets it apart for traditional computer clusters or traditional distributing computing. Various systems which can participate in the grid computing platform are Windows 3.1, 95, 98, networking, 2000 XP, and DOS operating system 2, support by Intel 86 and Mac OS, supported by Motorola 680X0, Mac OS AIX, Unix, HP, Digital Unix Open, VMS Window, Anti-Support, Compaq Alpha, VMS Ultrix, Solaris, AIX, and Eris. So these all are grid computing examples. So let's go to cluster computing. The concept of clustering is defined as the use of multiple computer, typically PC or Unix workstations. So this is basically Unix. And multiple storage devices and their interconnections to form the appear to user as a single highly available system. Workstation cluster is a collection of loosely connected processor where each workstation acts as an autonomous independent agent. So the cluster operates faster than normal system. So in general, a CPU cluster is about 250 to 300% faster than the single CPU PC. So besides, it not only reduces computational time but also allow the simulation of much bigger computation system models than before. Because of cluster computing, overnight analysis of computer, 3D injection molding, simulation for extremely complicated model is possible. Cluster workstation defined silicon graphic project is as follows. A distributed workstation cluster should be viewed as single computing resource and not as a group of individual workstations. So the details of cluster were 150 MHz, R4400 workstation, 64 MB memory, 1 GB disk per workstation, 16 to 17 monitors, cluster operating on local 10BASE-T Ethernet computing environment, status, PVM and MPI. And Oxford BSP lab. The operating system structure makes it difficult to exploit the characteristic of current clusters such as low latency communication, huge primary memory, high operating speed. Advances in network processor technology have greatly changed the communication and computational power of local area workstation clusters. Cluster computing can be used for load balancing in multi-process systems. A common use of cluster computing is balanced traffic load on high traffic websites. In web operation, a web page request is sent to manager server, which then determines which of the several identical or very similar web server to forward the request to for handling. So the use of cluster computing makes this web traffic uniform. So clustering has been available since 1980, and when it was used in DEC VMS systems. So IBM's SysSlex is a cluster approach for mainframe system. So Microsoft, Sun Microsoft System and other leading hardware and software company offer clustering packages for scalability as well as availability. So as traffic or availability assurance increases, all or some part of cluster can be increased in size or number. So cluster computing can also be used as relatively low cost form of parallel processing for scientific and other applications. So that lend themselves to parallel operations. An early and well-known example was project in which a number of the shelf PCs were used to form a cluster for scientific applications. Windows cluster is supported by symmetric multiple processors SMP and by Moldex 3D R7.1, while the users choose to start the parallel computing. The program will automatically partition one huge model into several individual domains and distribute them over different CPU for computing. Every computer node will exchange each other's computing data via message passing interface to get the final full model solution. So the computing task is parallel and processed simultaneously. Therefore, the overall computing time will be reduced greatly. Some famous projects on cluster computing are as follows. High net worth project. The primary aim details of load sharing facility resource management software. Types of users of LSFRMS. High net worth project developed by Bill McMillan, JISC NTI-65 and the HNW project, University of Glasgow. So the primary aim details of the project are creation of high performance computing environment using clustered workstations, use of pilot facility, use of spare capacity and use of cluster computing environment as a resource management. Use of ATM communications, parallel uses between sites across SuperGNet, and promoting awareness of project in community. So the famous project is cluster computing, is high net worth project, and the next one is the primary aim detail of load sharing facility resource management software LSFRMS are better resource utilization by routing the task to the most appropriate system and better utilization of busy workstation through load sharing and also by involving idle workstations. Types of users of LSFRMS, users whose computational requirements exceed the capability of their own hardware. Users whose computation requirements are too great to satisfy by single workstation. Users intending to develop code for use on a national resource. User who are using national resources, and user who wish to investigate less probable research scenarios. Advantages of using clustering: better resource utilization, reduced turnaround time, balanced load, and exploitation of more powerful hosts, access to non-local resources, and parallel distributed applications. So in our next video, we will discuss about Intel Architecture 64, IA64, EPYC Architecture IA32 support, and hyper-threading. Thanks for watching.